Dovasole is a favourite among top chefs because of its sweet flesh, but before I cook any, I want to hear a bit more from one of Hastings' longest-serving fishermen.
Hey there, Mark.
Oh.
Ah, good to see you. Come on down.
How are we doing?
I'm very good, thank you. And yourself?
Very well.
Good. How are you doing?
To see you. Yeah, very well.
Now, tell us about this place. Where does your fishing rights cover, then?
Well, personally, we fish from sort of Bexhill...
Yeah.
...down to sort of this side of Rye.
Yeah.
And probably out to 5 or 6 miles. We don't really go that far.
The reason Mark can haul bumper catches of Dovasole is that the waters along this bit of coast are perfect for them. As with most other flatfish, Dovasole live and feed on a sandy or silty sea floor. The gradual erosion of the chalk and sandstone cliffs here provide exactly that, which combined with the warm shallow water creates a perfect habitat for them, all within easy reach of the small fishing boats huddled along the beach at Hastings.
Now, it seems to me that it's kind of like a... Whereas pig farming's one thing, you know what you're producing. Here, it's kind of a lottery, isn't it?
Yeah, really?
You're going out after one particular thing, but you could end up with anything.
Yeah. That's very true. It's very much a mixed fishery here anyway, so, I mean... The other day there, we caught a lot of plaice, which we don't really want to catch.
Tell me about Dovasole then. Are you a fan of it? You go out
there
like and catch
Dovasole.
It?
Yeah, I do like Dovasole.
Because chefs really prize Dovasole. Must keep you happy, because it does...
We probably don't appreciate it, really, because we have so many of them.
And cooking it, what do you do with it then?
I grill the sole.
You grill the sole, right?
I grill the sole. I don't put anything... I don't like anything. I just like fish and a few chips.
You don't need anything else, do you?
No, what else do you want?
So many fishermen like their catch simply cooked that they can't all be wrong. But you don't need me to show you how to grill or fry a bit of fish in a bit of butter and stick it between two slices of fresh bread. So I'm going to try something a little bit more ambitious.
Now, it's unbelievable to think that these Dovasoles are caught, or some have caught, just literally over that harbour wall there. But they catch other things here too, and I've got a selection. The king of all, really, for me, flatfish, Dovasole. I actually love this. It's my ultimate flatfish. But you've got plaice and lemon sole, all of which are caught just off the headland there. Now, what I'm going to do with this is do like a classic meunière sort of style, which is called a brown butter, really. But I'm going to put the addition of capers, parsley and lemon in there as well. And what I did find is when I was wandering over there from a little shop, I found these little fellas here, these little brown shrimps. Now, I love these. They're often found in Morecambe. But they're delicious and going to go fantastically well with this.
My plan is that the bitterness of the lemon and the punch of the capers will make the natural sweetness of my brown shrimps and that prized Dovasole really complement each other.
First of all, you need to take the skin off. Now, what you need is a pair of scissors and trim off the fins. This would have to be my last supper, really, because a Dovasole tastes fantastic. Last time I had this was over in France, literally 70 odd miles in that direction. This was €100, this dish, but let's face it, what better place to have it than here, and cheaper.
The bones in Dovasole aren't very difficult to deal with when you're eating it, so I'm going to leave them in, which means all I have to do is take off the fins, tail, head and skin. This takes a bit of practice to do neatly, but your fishmonger will have loads of that. So you could get him to do it for you.
You're going to cook it the traditional way, which is just a little bit of flour, first of all, in plenty of oil. So we've got some plain flour here. Season this up. Salt and pepper. And then coat our fish in the flour. Just get rid of the excess flour. And cook it in olive oil, this one. So plenty of oil. We don't want to cook it in butter, because butter's going to burn. We use that for the sauce. This is purely to cook the fish. So straight in hot oil. And we cook this gently now for about 3 minutes on each side.
Thank you.
And now for the sauce for this. So while that's cooking, we're going to make our brown butter. So I want a little bit of shallot, just a small bit, but I'm going to finish this off with a lemon flower. And that's little Sammy over there. He's peeling a lemon with a spoon. It's always better to get somebody else to do that, really. It's far too fussy, but the secret of it is we just want all the rind and the pith removed from the lemon, so you end up just with a nice shaped lemon. Now I'm going to make a nice little sauce with this. You need some butter here into a really hot pan. You can see that hot? Just a small amount of butter. You know, it is me cooking it, of course. Throw the shallots in now, because obviously if you throw the shallots in too early, they're going to burn. So the butter just starts to colour, just ever so slightly. This is what the French call beurre noisette. It means nut brown butter. And when you create this, it just adds a lovely little flavour to it, and almost like a bitterness to the sauce. And then what we can do is add our lemon. Now, you need to be careful when you do this at home and keep this well away from your neck curtains, because this will go everywhere. So while it's still on the heat, lemon straight in. We'll swirl that around now in our pan. And take a little bit of muslin. And pass this through. So we don't really want any of the shallots. You can see the colour of the butter, what's happened in there now. And all those little bits. You can see the butter's changed colour in here as well. And then we can impart really the fundamental part of this dish, the flavour.
So into the butter sauce goes a handful of capers, parsley, and the shrimps, along with a grind of pepper and a pinch of salt. Mix that together and then spoon it onto the delicious Dover sole that's been so patiently waiting.
And then we've got our lemon flowers, which I've got over here. When we cut the lemon, you've got this lovely flower-shaped pattern.
Then simply lay the lemon flowers onto that superb piece of local Dover sole.
And then that's it. You've got a simple little dish. It's based on a classic Meunier sort of sauce, which is this literally nut brown butter that you can pour over the top. You can almost eat this just as it is. But you don't really want anything else. It's got to be the ultimate flat fish. And it's right on your doorstep, just out there.
This lovely fish and the small boats that work the shallow waters here are a good example of how we should all make the most of the bountiful supply of great food in this country. But I'm leaving Hastings now and the county of East Sussex to cross into Kent.